Hello and welcome to this lab session where we will once again create an EC2 instance and transform it into a web server. However, this time we will see how user data can help us do that. Last time we did that manually once the EC2 instance was up and running. We did SSH into it and then installed Apache and created index.html. by issuing commands. So let us get going first by creating the instance. This time we'll go a bit faster. Selection of AMI is done. Size selection done. And now VPC, subnet, auto assign IP, everything is cool. The only thing that we need to do here is we will provide user data and all the commands that we issued last time, we will be providing the same commands in user data. So, yes, we did yum update hyphen y, yum update dash y, httpd, all these commands we issued last time as well, but after the EC2 instance was up and running, we SSH'd into it and then we did all these. This time, by providing these commands as user data, what we are doing is we are expecting that when EC2 instance will be up and running and it will be available to us, it will already be a web server. That is, all these commands would have been issued and the index.html page created and through the static IP, public IP, we can access this. Let us see if that is possible. Add storage, add tags, configure security group. Last time we created a security group, right? This one. It had both 80 and 22 open. So we will use that. Review and launch. Let us use the same key pair. I acknowledge it. Launch instances. I'll be pausing it for the time it takes for instance to come up. So now the instance should be up and running and we will expect it to have become a web server. Let us see that. Okay. Yep. Hello world from the host name of this EC2 instance. So the last one is still open. Hello world from IP 172.31.15.5. This is hello world from IP 172.31.15.140. Okay. So it means our script, user data script, is working. Great. That's exactly what we wanted to achieve in this lab session. In fact, we'll be using user data a lot in coming lessons. Thank you and looking forward to seeing you in next lesson.